Hey everyone, welcome back to Watch and Carry. So in today's video, we're going to be doing another modification for a Casio. So I posted a video a couple, actually I think it was last week, of a mod that I did. And it had been probably a month or two since I had done a mod previously. And having finished that mod last week, I just kind of got the bug. You know, I kind of missed making some custom Casios. So I went to my spare parts bin, fished out some things that weren't being used, and I said, hey, let's experiment today. Let's throw some things out and see if we can come up with a pretty cool design to make. So some parts you're gonna be needing for this project, some straps that you have. The Casio uses an 18 millimeter lug, so it has to have an 18 millimeter end or a 18 millimeter lug adapter at the very least. You're going to be needing some fluids here. So I have this bowl that I kind of divide into half like there. On the right side, we have Goo Gone. So this is what the bottle looks like for Goo Gone. Okay. And I'll explain why later. And then on the left side, I'll be using that to put my super glue. You're going to need these fine tipped Q-tips. I'll get to the watch parts in a bit. For tools, micro screwdriver, scalpel, tweezers, your lug tool, a pair of scissors, Sharpie can be helpful. Then we go into our filters. So we are using today Leaf Filter Chrome Orange number 179. If you don't want to buy this whole packet, you can just order that color separately. So far, the best price I found is on eBay. You would just go ahead and type in this exact title into eBay and it should pop up. And then we have our polarized filter here. This is 0 degree polarized filter. You can see the zero there. And this filter has the option for an adhesive back. So it's kind of like a sticker, but transparent. Okay, so for the watch parts, go into the description below. You're gonna be needing two watches for this. So this is a Casio AE1300 and I forgot the sub model. So check below for that. This is the one that comes in that gray case. And we're not going to be using the gray case, but we are going to be taking the masking and the watch module off of that watch and using those parts. And then you're going to be needing a Skmei, spelled S-K-M-E-I. This is their gold case, and so we're just going to be using the case off of the Skmei. All right. So those are a few of the things you're going to be needing. Nothing too expensive, nothing too difficult. During this whole process, I'll go ahead and try to film as much as I can, but certain parts that are repetitive and long and tedious, I'll go ahead and just pause the video so you guys don't get too bored. Roughly, what are we going to be making today? So we're going to be doing a gold case. We're going to be using this kind of masking, this watch module, and then for now, I'm kind of liking this green strap. This green strap came off of a different Skmei digital. Also check the comments, or also check the description down below, okay? Off of the watch module, I'm gonna convert the bottom lower portion where the time and the date are into a negative display using our filter that we talked about. And then in the top here, right here in the masking, gonna flip that guy over, and that's where we're gonna put the chrome orange leaf filter, right? So it's gonna be like very black, white lettering or characters here, orange, and then I feel like that orange and black plays off well with the gold and the green, or this olive drab that you're gonna be getting together as one package. All right, kind of gives me, I don't know, kind of like a camping theme or an outdoor theme. All right, so first step we're gonna be doing is focusing on the watch module. So let's set these parts out to the side here. Now with this watch module, you're gonna have to take this apart. So pretty easy, you've got 2, 4, 6 tabs. So you got one tab here. Okay, you're gonna go ahead and pry that off. Another one on the opposite side. And then these two usually just kind of fall off like that. All right, so there's your two halves right there. Okay, now on this part, when you take this apart, just be very cautious about this spring here. Okay, so what I like to do is I just like to go ahead and remove that right away so that I don't lose track of it, which I already did. There it is. So we're gonna put that spring in our little bin here. So also nice to have this work mat, which you can also get off of Amazon or AliExpress. Okay, let's dive back in here. Okay, so for this part, you can set this to the side now. This is as disassembled as we're going to get it. Put that over there. We'll focus on this guy here. You're gonna remove this board here. Try to use plastic when touching this circuit board so you don't touch metal to metal. Okay, and then when you flip that over, you're gonna be having this little sheet here. If that sticks on, you can keep it there. If it comes off, not a big deal. Just set that guy to the side there. And I'll show you guys how to reassemble everything later. So let's put that down there. And then here, what you're gonna be doing is taking off this little opaque display, set that to the side. And then you have these two little foam spacers. I don't know exactly what these do, but I know they're very important. So actually, let's go ahead and pop this off first. So what you'll do here to pop this guy off is you'll look for the end that has the shorter foam. You see how this foam here is short, this one is long. So go to the short side and you can see there's a little bit of a plastic spring right here. You're gonna take your finger and pull in this direction to the right. And as you're doing that, push down with your left thumb. And that removes the main display or the panel. Okay, and that's the guy we're gonna be working on. This part you can set to the side. If these foam things come off, really not big of a deal. I'm gonna take mine out just so that I can show you how to reassemble it later. So we'll set those things to the side as well. And this is what I'm talking about with the foam. Okay, set that to the side. All right, so now that that's here, we got all our parts off, I'm going to actually reassemble this back in the way that I put it in. So these three dots, okay, are gonna go to the part that does not have that spring. Remember that spring here that I talked about? These three dots go opposite that. So we're gonna reinsert, and you kind of put the display underneath like that, underneath these two clips here, and then you push down and you'll hear a click. Okay, there we go. And so now the display is kind of reattached back inside, okay. All right, and then we'll go ahead and take our masking here and then put that on the top like that, okay. And so the reason why we reassemble it is just to hold this masking in place. And it's important to hold this masking in place because now we have to draw our cut line where we're gonna make the negative display, okay? So what I like to do is keep these parts together, okay? Go to the side where you have the white and then follow like this invisible line here. You see these two dots, one and two? Draw a line there in your mind, extend that line out here to the end, and then draw it here on the white, like that. So I made a little Sharpie mark. Do the same here. Extend that line out. Kind of like that, and then it would be right about here. Another Sharpie mark, okay. Then we'll take the masking off, okay. Now go to your first Sharpie mark, or your second, doesn't really matter. And then now extend that Sharpie mark onto the actual display. So like right there. Okay, so make a mark, then do the same on the opposite side. Okay, find that Sharpie mark and then extend it onto the display. Okay, so now what we've done is we've made two dots here on the display, and then we'll go ahead and connect the dots, okay? So, another tool I forgot to mention, this is my straight edge. It's actually a old wallet comb that no longer I use. So I'm gonna put this right here on the display. Now this is metal, okay? So since I am cutting off this part of the display that I'm marking with an X, right? It's okay to put metal on top of that display. Don't put it here, the metal, because the metal will scratch the part of the display that you're keeping. But down here, I'm cutting this all off and removing it, so it doesn't matter. So now you connect those two dots together, okay? And then draw a straight edge across. Perfect, just like that. Okay, now what we'll do is we'll double check our line that we drew. And what we're hoping for is that this line that we drew here, which is where we're going to be cutting with our scalpel, is going to be right along this part of the masking. So that way, when we reassemble the watch, you don't see a big cut line in the glass of the display. It's blocked by this part of the masking. That's why we're drawing that line. So you can see when I line up my masking here, it's perfectly blocking that line that we just drew. Okay. All right. So now we can go ahead and start cutting this part out. Okay. So you can either take out the display again here from this white frame housing, or you can just leave it on. For me, it's easier to grab onto something thick, so I'm going to leave it on there. Okay. And then what you'll do is you'll just lightly score. Don't go for a really big, deep, a large pressure cut right away, because what happens is, number one, the more force you apply with something sharp, the higher incidence of this thing slipping and, cutting you or cutting something you don't want to. Number two, this is a single piece of what looks like glass. If you push too hard and you're not cutting, you're gonna crack the glass completely around. You might have like hairline cracks here and here, and then now this whole display is useless. So what we're going for is really firm but gradual pressure. So some amount of pressure, a little bit more pressure, repeat the pressure. You're going to keep going over and over and over till that score line gets deeper and deeper. And then finally, you'll feel it when the glass cuts. Now, it's hard for me to explain how deep you want to go with the cut, but basically, you'll know when you reach the display. Basically, this display has several layers. And so, really, there's three main layers. And so, the top layer where we're going to be cutting is here. Think about that as one of the buns of your hamburger. Then you have this middle part, like the patty, and then you have the back part here on the reverse, which is like another bun. So we're leaving these two parts and we're just cutting the top over here. Okay, so we'll go ahead and zoom in a little bit more so you can see. There we go. And let's go ahead and draw our score lines. So nice. Great. Now I'm going to repeat that same thing again, adding a little bit more pressure. And then a third time, even a little bit more pressure. Okay. Then I'm going to reverse this over, and I like to cut from the other side as well. So that way, this really breaks evenly or removes evenly once we get down to the part of the glass that we're going to be removing. So, same score line. And one more time. All right. I'm going to pause the video here. Keep doing this three, 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 and three. I would do that maybe like five or six more times. If you feel like you've gone through the first layer already, go ahead and stop and then rejoin the video when I come back. Okay, so now what we're going to do is take this display off the white frame, set that guy to the side. Some other stuff you're going to be needing. You'll need like a towel, paper towel. I like to use a microfiber towel like this. Okay. And then you're going to be needing a small pin. And if you have it, the best thing would be a guitar pick. So there's my guitar pick. And here is my pin off of my Victorinox. Okay. So what we need to do is kind of, we've made our score line here. What we're trying to do now is separate this half from this half, but just the bun. there's still going to be two layers below that we're not going to touch. We're just touching the top portion. Now, this top portion, the bun, is glued to the patty, so to speak, all right? And so that glue, you can't just go in there and pry it off. It's a lot easier if you use a chemical. So that's where your Goo Gone is going to be coming in handy. So what I like to do here is grab a little Goo Gone. Do this over your towel, really saturate it, and then go to that lower portion only and just kind of, press that Q-tip in. So that way, a lot of that Goo Gone seeps into there. Okay. And then do it on the bottom as well. You can be generous with the Goo Gone here. And then the other side here. Okay, and then we'll do that again. Okay, and then I'm gonna let that sit for about a minute, so I'll come back. Okay, so another thing you can do here, if you look here to the left, is I've kind of submersed just the lower half, not the top half, into the Goo Gone. The display, and I just kind of let it sit there for about a minute, just enough to get it loose. Okay, so now we'll take this off. Okay, we'll go ahead and dry it just a little bit so it doesn't slip in our hands. And then we'll take our pin, and what you'll do is you'll start on the edge. So either here, or here, or here. And what we want to do is just get like a small indentation in that pin. Basically, again, we got bun, patty, bun. We're removing this bun. What we're doing is we're sticking our pin right between these two only. So that way we can get it loose. Then we'll take our guitar pick, which is softer and safer, and then remove the rest of this bun off, and then clean the glue here with the rest of the Goo Gone that was adhering these two layers together. So hopefully that visual makes sense for you. So get your pin. Make sure that you're obviously not pushing this in the direction of your finger because it can slip. And what we'll do is we'll just kind of do a small, let's see if I can zoom in more here for you. Small puncture here till you see like a small air pocket. There you go. You see that? Small air pocket right there. And that's all you need. You can take the pin out now. Okay, and then we'll take our guitar pick here. And then what we'll do is just kind of go right where we made that air pocket. And then try to lift it up a bit. If you have a hard time lifting up, take your pin again and maybe go more towards the edge, which might be easier to get your guitar pick into. Again, there's our air pocket. We're making it a little bit wider, and then you can turn the pin left and right gently. Make sure you don't crank down this way on the pin because you don't want to damage the display beneath it. Okay, and then take our guitar pick and slowly work at this. There we go. So we got that in now. All right, so now what we'll do is we'll just slowly work at this filter. I like to go from the bottom up to the top where we have our score line, okay? If you reach an area here where you have a lot of resistance, you can go ahead and stop, take this out, take your Q-tip with the Goo Gone and put a little bit more to get down into that crevice. But this is going pretty well. So I'm just rocking this back and forth, and you can see that I'm slowly working at this. Now, once you start getting close to the score line, what I'd like to do is stop there. Don't go all the way to the score line because sometimes what happens is if your score line is not thick enough, what'll happen is you'll not only pry up on this lower portion, you'll start prying up on the upper portion. The minute you pry up just a tab, just a bit on an area that you don't want, you're gonna get all this glue residue that appears, and then now this whole thing is ruined. So right when we get close to, but not at the score line, I choose one of the sides. So I'd like to go here to the right, and then I really start to just work at this edge here, trying to get this guitar pick to separate this half from this half, okay? So we'll go really easy. Don't force this too much. Let the guitar pick do the work. So rock it gently. If you feel like it's not biting. Basically, if you feel like the score line is not tearing with your guitar pick movement, stop there, take your scalpel, and then rescore that same line that you just did earlier. Okay? And you can go back and forth here. And then switch over and we'll do that again. And then, since we have a lot of plastic or glass residue sticking up all over the place, just so we don't get splintered by that, I'll take some tape and remove that. It also helps remove that so that way you don't accidentally grind this plastic material into the top display, which you're keeping and you want to keep pristine. All right, so now what we'll do is we'll take our guitar pick again and then try to go at that score. And there you go. You see how easy that broke now? Really separated that half from that half. Nice and easy. So helps to kind of slow down a bit. And now we can go ahead and glide our guitar pick. Again, if this is difficult to glide your pick through, stop. Go ahead and take a little bit more Goo Gone with your tooth, with your Q-tip and reapply. It's a little bit of chemical and mechanical work that you're trying to do, okay? And so both of those things should hopefully help you remove this off. And that's great. So let's look at that. You see that? Came off nice and clean. Perfect. So this we can go ahead and set aside. Don't throw this away, actually. This might come in handy depending on how you measure your polarized filter later. Now we're going to go back to our display here. And we'll make sure that we have a nice flat surface here. I shouldn't be seeing any residual material from here, which we just removed. And usually what happens is right here on the score line, you can get a little bit of that excess material that will stay put. So you want to remove that because you want this to be flat to give the polarized filter a chance to adhere properly. Okay, so that looks like a pretty clean break actually. So again, I'll take my tape here and let's get those splinters off. Okay, so you can see here, right in the corner, I still have a little bit of glass. So I'll take my scalpel again and then just re-score that tiny section only. And then we'll take our guitar pick and try to get that little piece off. Just be very gentle. Okay, if that doesn't work, you can take your pin from earlier. Just be careful. There we go. And now you can see that little portion that's coming off there. So take our tape and try to get that off. There we go. So now what you're left with here is just glue residue. That's what all this dirty crud is here. So we need to remove that before we put our polarized filter on. So again, go back to our Goo Gone. And then you're going to really be generous with this, okay? So saturate your Q-tip and go over this entire lower portion only, okay? And one more. All right. And then what I like to do is let that sit for a minute or two, and then we will come back and start working at this with Q-tips to remove that glue. So I'll check back with you. Okay. So it's been about 5 minutes now. We'll go ahead and start working at this. So to work on this, you're just going to take your Q-tip and just kind of make small circles. What's going to start happening is the glue will start clumping together. This is probably the longest part of making a negative display, is getting the glue off. The display really needs to be completely clear and clean. So okay, once you feel like you've gotten a few clumps of glue together, you can kind of see those clumps here. You can go ahead and discard that Q-tip, take your towel. Microfiber, I think, is best. It doesn't scratch that much, and just kind of wipe off those clumps. Take a new Q-tip and repeat the whole process again. So put a nice film of Goo Gone and then get working. All right, so I'm gonna keep doing this. This can take, I don't know, I've done this as quick as 5 minutes. I've taken as long as 20. So it really depends on just how much glue was applied from the factory. But you'll keep doing this, thin layer, buff, wipe off, repeat until this display is completely clean. So I'll pause here and then check back with you guys once I get to that last step. Okay, so that was about 10 minutes that I was off camera there. So it took me a while. I was having, quite a bit of residue here. You'll notice it's a little bit harder to remove the glue residue here along the score line. I had some different parts here that also had some glue. So again, if you're rubbing a lot, nothing's coming off, take your time. Saturate this area in glue. Take a step back, take a break for a few minutes, come back, let the chemical do its work, and then, kind of go back with the Q-tip and work it out. But eventually you want to get the display, as clean as possible. So kind of like that. All right. So you are doing great, guys. You've basically done what I think is like the hardest and most tedious part. Okay. So next thing we're going to do is measure the polarized filter. So we want to cut our polarized filter to be exactly the size of the bun, so to speak, that we just removed off. So we can set our display to the side there. We will take our polarized filter and we'll cut this out. Now, this can be a little bit tricky if you've never worked with polarized filters before. So you have to have this filter cut in a certain orientation for the negative display, which is what I'm wearing here, to really pop out. So, to understand where that would be, we need to actually reassemble our watch and look for a black out colored change. So that will make more sense in a little bit. So, let's go ahead and really wipe this off. Take your watt module, go over the edges in the towel, really get that dry as much as you can. Okay. All right, then let's go ahead and reassemble. So we'll grab our parts here, grab our foam. Put these here to the side. And what else did we use here? Yeah, this little divider and these two parts here. Okay, make sure your towel's nice and dry. So to reassemble, again, look for that short spring. You see that little spring here on the side? That's going to be always your 6 o'clock position. In fact, if you really just want to keep it simple, go ahead and draw a little mark here in Sharpie, and that's your 6 o'clock position for the rest of this project. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll take our display and go underneath the clips on the 12 o'clock and the 6 o'clock position and clip this in like that. Okay, you can see those clips right here. They should be on top of the display. Those are the clips right there. So the display's underneath that. Flip this guy over. Okay. We'll grab our foam spacers. If anybody knows the actual name of these, that would be much appreciated. Put in the comments down below. Reinsert them. They're both different sizes, so they can only go in one slot each. like that. Great. And then what's next here? We'll take our opaque display. Now with your opaque display, you have these raised edges here, these little teeth. Let's see if I can show this better. Okay, you have these little teeth here, okay? And those teeth are more pronounced towards one side. You see how it's raised here to the left, but flat on the right? The raised edge should be facing your face, so pointing upwards towards you. And those two teeth should be on the same side as this long spacer. So we'll reassemble that there. Oh, sorry. Those two teeth should be on the short spacer side, not the long one. So short side, kind of like that. Okay, then we will take this part here. And the way that this works is you put this with the black pieces facing towards you. It doesn't matter if it's this way or if it's this way, it's all the same. Okay, so we'll reassemble that. Okay, like that. Then we're gonna go ahead and take our board here. Again, try to limit touching the contacts as much as possible. And this part actually goes to, let's see here. Right, okay, just like that. So you're gonna take this part of your watch module, look for these two contacts here. That contact touches this. This contact touches that. So that's how you will know which orientation to put this in. And then this black square should be facing up towards you. Okay. And then you can just kind of press that in. Oh, sorry. Before you do that, take your spring. That little spring we talked about earlier. And then with these two contacts on the 6 o'clock position, you're going to put this spring right here. Okay, there's a little hole between those two contacts right in there. The spring, by the way, has a skinny end and a fatter end. The fatter end at this point faces towards you. So you insert that spring, take your board here. Okay, kind of like that. The other way you can do this is take that black square and put that black square facing down in the middle of these four rectangles like this, okay? And you can put it facing down like that. And when you do that, you will notice that there will be a tooth here that pops up through the white frame and another tooth here that pops up through the white frame. So this is another way you can put it together. Okay, again, we're gonna go ahead and reassemble. Remember, your spring should be inserted here. These two contacts should match these two contacts, okay? And then we'll go ahead and turn this over. And then we'll go back to our clips here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay? And we'll reinsert those guys together. Now, what you'll be noticing here when this happens is the display might seem a little miscolored for now. That's completely normal. The bottom display will not be displaying, of course, because we've removed the visible portion. Without this bottom portion, the time won't show. But what's interesting here is if you see me put this back here, and let's reset this battery also, by the way. So to reset, you're gonna take your paper clip and you're gonna look for the AC button here. Okay, you're gonna stick that there and then touch the other end of the paperclip to any other metal part, doesn't matter. Take that off, okay. You'll notice that the top now starts to display because we've reset the watch. The bottom is invisible, but if I put this part that we just cut off, it's now visible, right? Okay, so now we're gonna go ahead to our polarized filter. And this is why we had to reassemble this, so that way we know the orientation to put this. So for example, had I not reassembled the watch, I couldn't see the characters here at the bottom. And if I cut my filter like this, that looks nothing like this, right? No black and no gold lettering, right? It looks more of like a weird, odd purple. So now if I turn this filter this way, oh, now we're starting to get a negative display, right? So I'll go ahead and do it this way, and you can see that depending on your orientation, you will get that desired effect. So now I know the orientation in which to cut my polarized filter. Okay. So now that I know that I need to be facing this way for my filter, I can go ahead and actually, you can either trace this part that you cut off onto here, or with the polarized filter laid on top of the watch, you can just go ahead and kind of trace the inside portion here in Sharpie. Okay, kind of like that. Great. And then we'll go ahead and cut this guy out. Okay, and then before we even remove the backing, we'll go ahead and lay it on top just to test fit to make sure that this is not too large. If you cut this polarized filter too large and it starts overlapping onto this white plastic, it will be uneven. The white plastic is slightly elevated than the display here. And so if you have two different levels that you're putting this filter over, you'll have some air bubbles that develop, so you don't want that. So this really should be cut precisely to fit the exact portion of that display that you cut off. And you can kind of put it there and kind of move it side to side and make sure that it's not jumping, right? If this was too large, what you would be noticing is that it would easily come off like this. But see, I slide that there. I move my finger. It's kind of trapped by the display above and the white frame below into the side. So I know that that's a good size. Okay. Now with this polarized filter, we'll go ahead and take this off. Okay, make sure this display, of course, is clean and dry. You don't want to be putting this on wet. Okay, and then for this type that I bought, it's an adhesive backing. So I go ahead and peel the back here to remove the sticker or to remove the protect the film over the sticker. And then now the sticky part is facing down. I'm going to go ahead and just slide this up till I meet the display here and it won't go any further up. And then kind of set it down into place like that. Okay. And just push that guy in. All right. Now, what you can do is take something like you can just take your finger actually. And there's actually still another film over this right now that I need to remove that I'm rubbing over. So don't worry about getting fingerprints on this. Don't worry about these displays kind of being distorted by the pressure of your finger. Don't push too hard, of course, but just kind of rub this back and forth to kind of get the polarized filter adhered. Okay. Once that's good, go ahead and take something thin and kind of remove that protective film. So there's that protective film, and we'll just peel that off. And that looks pretty good. Now what we'll do is we'll go back here and we'll try to take a look for any blemishes. So I can already see a big one right here in the corner. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll take something soft, like maybe a brand new Q-tip, and kind of work that out. Try to press that in. Okay. If it looks like it's not going away, you might have to actually lift up on it and reset the polarized filter. You might have to take something like your pin again and carefully lift up. All right, so Q-tip, get that air bubble out of there. Maybe press inside to outside to kind of remove it. And then that looks pretty good. Okay. Then what we're going to do is kind of test fit this with our masking. So take our masking here and making sure that that looks clean. Actually, let me reset the watch again so we can get that top portion going. There we go. Put our masking and then we'll kind of take a look back. And so what I want to make sure is that I don't see any exposed bare glass beneath this polarized score line beneath here or up here in the window. So that looks great. Okay, let's set that to the side. Let's now focus just on the masking and get our orange filter going. So you've pretty much done it at this point if you've stuck with this. This is pretty much cake from here on out. So we'll go to our filter here, and I'm using up just the remainder of this. I actually just ordered a brand new set of this color, so that should be coming in the mail next week. In the meantime, we will scavenge what we can from this. There we go. Perfect. All right, so with your filter here, you'll take your masking, flip the masking over, and then if you've seen my other video, you kind of know what to do here. Kind of line it up in the back. Take your Sharpie. Make sure this filter looks nice and clean. Okay. And we'll just go ahead and trace where we're going to cut here. So, right there looks good. And then we'll cut off this corner here. And then this corner will kind of go down like that, so to speak. All right, grab our scissors, cut this out. And then clean this up. Okay, so that looks pretty good. Now what we can do is go ahead and clean this filter. So grab your clean microfiber, different one than the one you used for the Goo Gone, and just kind of wipe that off. Just trying to remove that oily fingerprints. Okay, and then take your tweezers and set this guy to the side. So I like to set it right there so it's easy to pick up. Okay, let's go to our masking here. Okay, we'll go ahead and grab our super glue now. So just a bit. Brand new Q-tip. Really helps to use these fine-tipped ones. Okay. Don't have a huge glob of it, just enough. And focus on applying glue as high up as possible. Like that. And then maybe a little bit here at the edge. And one more edge here. Okay, and then I'll put one dab here, just a dot, and then another dot right there, like that. Okay, we'll set that guy to the side. Then we'll take our filter. And then apply that in. Okay. And then take something blunt and clean. So I have this Q-tip here. Kind of press in your edges. Okay, now, as I mentioned in a previous video, you'll notice that I don't apply glue really close to the cutout openings here. I like to apply my glue towards the end because when you push this filter down and squeeze it, the glue is going to spread. And if it spreads too close to the opening, you're going to be seeing glue appear here in these windows. So that's why I like to keep the glue all at the edges. Okay. Then if you really want to secure it a little bit more, what you can do is grab a little bit more glue and then just dab it halfway between the masking and the filter, like one little dot there, and then you one more here. Okay. And then we'll set that guy to the side to dry. So I'm gonna let that sit for about a minute or two and then I'll come back. Okay, so that's been drying now. So what we'll do is we'll prep our case, okay? This looks like the 12 o'clock position. So I'll take my my air can in. Okay, turn this over, give this a quick blast to get any dust out of there. Okay, turn it face down so the we don't get any air in there or dust in there. Take your display here. If you have any fingerprints, go ahead and at this point just kind of wipe it off. Okay, if you haven't already, if the clock is not running, make sure you do a hard reset on your or a reset on your watch. Again, you just go to that back, find that little AC hole, insert one end of a paper clip there, and then bend the paper clip and touch the other end of the paper clip to another piece of metal like this this frame here. Okay, but mine is running, so we won't go ahead and do that. And then give this a blast of air as well. And then we'll go to our masking. Okay, and the masking, we'll go ahead and kinda touch that up also. Once you flip it over to this side, be gentle with the air so it doesn't rip the filter off the masking. Kind of check it for any fingerprints that you might have. If you do, what you can do is support it from behind and then wipe off that area with fingerprints and then the reverse for this as well. But this looks good, okay? Make sure your super glue, of course, is dry before manipulating the back because you don't want to get any super glue sticking to like your Q-tip or the fibers of your cloth, and then now you have those hairs being visible on the display. Okay, then we'll go and reassemble our watch. So take your masking. The three dots go to the 12 o'clock position. So we'll turn this over, put our masking inside. Okay, just like that. Now, because this is a Casio watch module, but this is a Skmei case, this is a little bit of a tight fit to go into this case, but it can be done. So you just have to be patient and really insert this even. So don't do one side, like don't like do this, and then the other side, you really have to put it in flat. But it will go in, you just have to be patient. There, so really tight fit, okay? And then push that down. Okay, make sure your clips here aren't riding on the case as you're pushing down because you don't want to rip those clips. Okay, then what you'll do is you'll find these little prongs or tongs here. So here are your pushers and then here are your tongs. You want to make sure that the tong is behind the pusher inside the case. So we'll just push, pull back a little bit while pushing down. So press with your thumb, pull back on this tong, pull back on that one, do the other two. That looks good. Okay, now we'll go to our O-ring. Okay, if this feels pretty dry, go ahead and give it a quick lube. So mine actually feels a little bit dry here. So this is Hops number 9 oil. Just put a little bit between your fingers. Okay, and then kind of pull the length of the O-ring. Okay, and then wipe off any extra if there is. Set this carefully down. It looks good. Take our watch case. All right. Now you have to be exact with this. So in order for your button sound, you know how sometimes when you push the buttons, it makes a little chime? That spring that we inserted earlier has to contact this circular patch on the case back. If it doesn't, you won't have that sound because this is actually where your speaker is. So the spring is here on mine. So I just need to make sure that that circle is going to line up with that spring. If I had put it in this way, then I wouldn't have any sound. So I need to put it in this way. You also won't have any alarm if you don't assemble this correctly. Okay. Now before I screw in, I'll go ahead and just kind of turn the watch around, make sure it looks good. Check for my O-ring here, make sure it's not being pinched anywhere. And then we can put some pressure here, grab our screws that we took off earlier, and start reassembling this. Yeah, I just loosely tighten those two just to get it started. Okay, and then fully tighten. Don't over-tighten because you have metal screws going into a plastic case, and so it's easy to strip the threads in the gold plastic case. So that looks good. Okay. Now before I proceed further, I'll go ahead and test the functions here. Okay. So stopwatch, start, clear, timer. Clear and then main time, and then we'll test the light to make sure that works. So kind of hard to see. There you go. That's better. It's actually much better in person. This looks like it's not working right now, but I think it's just my lighting because I actually can see this really easily in front of me. Let me see if I can get a good view. There you go. Okay. All right, so I actually had to pause the video there. I noticed a mistake that I made. I was really trying to avoid this, so I apologize. Hopefully, you are watching this all the way through before attempting this. So I'm not getting any sound, which means that my spring is not contacting the speaker here. So what that tells me is this spring was placed incorrectly. So here, this is the 6 o'clock position of the watch, by the way. You can see that I put the spring right here at the 6 o'clock position, but actually it looks like the spring needs to be just to the left of the AC. So you see the AC here? That's where we did our hard reset with the paper clip. Just to the left of that, your spring needs to go. So I'm going to take this out again. Really sorry if this inconveniences you guys. And we'll have to take this all apart again, flip our case over. Okay, quickly disassemble this. Getting rusty. I haven't done these in a while. Okay, take apart our watch case again. Then we're going to focus just on this part here. We'll take apart our spring. So dump it like that. Okay, go to your AC button there and then find that hole, which should be there at the very top. Okay, and then we'll take our spring here and reinsert the skinny end of the spring into that little hole. Okay. So right there at the top like that. Okay, right there. Okay, go ahead and put this back. Okay, again, make sure these two contacts are making contact with these two. Turn this over. And then reclip everything again. Okay, you can do a hard reset now again. So find your AC button. Again, spring here, AC button here. Paper clip, metal to metal. Touch, verify that the clock is running again. Okay, clean this off. Okay, take our case again, flip that over, dust off our masking again, dust off our case again. Okay, make sure this is the 12 o'clock position, insert the masking, tap it down. Oh, there's a little bit of dust there, let me get that out. There we go. Watch module in. Okay, press those little tongues inside. So push with your index finger, pull back on each tongue. One, two, three, four. Okay, that looks good. Take our O-ring, reinsert that. Okay, our spring is here. So when we install our case back, make sure that this part of the case back is touching that spring, right? So it should go like this. Reinsert, okay? I can go ahead and test to make sure that that sound is working now, so you can hear it. I probably should have done that before I screwed it in the first time, so. Insert your screws. Okay, check the O-ring is not, check that the O-ring is not being pinched. Okay, and then fully tighten once you're confident that everything looks good. Okay, now that looks better. Okay, and we'll test all the functions again. Okay, it looks good. And then the backlight, which doesn't look good on camera. Actually, that looks better. There you go. It's actually very visible in person, so it's a lot better than it looks. Okay, so we've got the watch done. Let's go ahead to the strap, okay? So this is the strap we're working with. Again, this comes off of a different Skmei watch. Check the model down in the description. This comes usually with a silver, what do you call this, clasp. But what I'm gonna do is I'd like to take the Casio clasp off of this standard AE Casio. So this one right here came with this strap. And I'd like to have that Casio clasp, or buckle, I guess I should say, this Casio buckle with the print Casio on it transferred onto here. So that way I think the black goes better with the green, and also you get a little bit of that logo here as well. Okay, so what you need to do here is the pin that comes with the Skmei is very hard. So what you'll do is you'll try to separate this buckle in this direction. So kind of pull it apart like that, okay? All right, so we'll separate it out. I'm just kind of pulling. And then kind of prying it off like that, okay? And then what we'll do is we'll take that off. And this one that comes with the Skmei is not a true spring bar. It's a different type, so we can set that to the side and not use that anymore. Okay, we'll take our Casio clasp, okay? And then you will need a spring bar here, and I believe this is 12 millimeters in length. Let's see here. 10, 15, 16, I'm sorry, 17 millimeter spring bar. So okay, so we measure our spring bar, and this should be about 17, okay? And the way you measure a spring bar is from this end, not this tip, but this end, all the way to the tip here. So this looks like 15, 16, 17. This actually looks more like an 18 millimeter spring bar. And the one we removed was, I guess, 18 also. So I guess 18 is what you're looking for, okay? Okay, we'll go ahead and insert this halfway in, take this portion of the buckle, skewer it all the way through like that. Take our Casio buckle here, and then insert like that. So that looks cool. Now we've got a Casio logo buckle on that one. All right, now it comes time to reassembling, okay? So we'll put the short side of the strap at the 12, the long side at the 6, flip this guy over, take our 22 millimeter spring bars from before, I'm sorry, our 18 millimeter spring bars, insert that in, insert one end into the hole first, okay? Rest the other end on top like that. Take your spring bar tool, pull it back, and give it a little jiggle. Repeat again. Insert. Insert one end in, rest it on top, pull it back, give it a little jiggle. Okay, and let's take a look at how the finished product is. So that looks good. Pretty awesome. I kind of like it. I don't know. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. So we have here these orange inserts, the negative display now, and then the gold case with the green and the black buckle. I don't know, in general, especially just a lot of hiking coats or clothing or tents I've seen, gold and green seem to go really well together, and then black and orange seem to be nice little accent pieces that you add to that. I like how the black buckle here kind of ties in that black with the case, and then the orange kind of complements the green visually. At this point, if you want to make it a clean case, what you can do is you can take more of your Goo Gone and scrub off the lettering here. So this says dual time here, and it said illuminator here. I went ahead and I removed illuminator, and I'm debating whether I want to remove dual time. So for now, I'll just go ahead and leave that part on, okay? So let's put this on the wrist and see how this looks. This is actually my other Casio I'm wearing today. It's kind of the opposite of this green case with a gold bracelet, Skmei bracelet, and this is a green Casio AE 1300 or 1200. Okay. And that's how it looks. Pretty cool. Not too bad. All right, so that'll do it for today's video, guys. Again, sorry for that little mistake with the speaker, but hopefully the rest of the instructions make sense and go smoothly for you. If you have any comments or questions, please put them down below. And as always, have fun, and I'll see you guys on the next one.